Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, please, you're welcome. Please subscribe. If you're part of our returning community, member of our village people in this channel, you're very much welcome. Today, we're talking about NYSC experience, so stay tuned. So, NYSC. Guys, I served in Kebbi State. Before NYSC, I had lived all my life in Enugu. I did my nursery school in Enugu. Let me start. I was born in Enugu. I did my nursery school in Enugu. I did my primary school in the Ofot, Enugu. I did university in Enugu. I had lived, rooted, been brought up in Enugu. So I think NYSC was made for people like me. To go somewhere else. Kebbi is like the other side of the world in Nigeria. It's not NYSC's fault though. I feel Kebbi, you know, you get to have fun when you're registering, you put in four states. I put Plateau, Kebbi, Ogun State. I can't remember the last picture. But I put Kebbi and they put me there. But luckily for me, I went to NYSC with my sister. Yeah, we did not work it though. I mean, if we were working something, we work it chemistry. Think about it. No, of course we won't. But luckily for me, I was going there with a familiar face. So let me start from the traveling. Guys, I traveled by road because your girl didn't got the money to fly. So we started out by going from Enugu to Jos. We got to Jos around past it, almost 10 to 12 hours. We got to Jos. The next day, we're headed out to Sokoto. From Sokoto, we're going to get to Kebbi. But when we got to the park, luckily for us, there were lots of core members going to Kebbi. So they decided to bring out a bus for people going to Kebbi. So in the bus, we had a lot of, you know, fellow core members. We started our journey around, left Jos around like 9. Then I think we got to Zaria. Guys, Zaria is like the next place once you leave Plateau State. No, we hadn't even gotten to Zaria. Our vehicle spoiled. Our vehicle spoiled. We luckily for us, we were in town, so we went to a mechanic and fixed the car. They're going again. It did not last 1 hour. 1 hour, it did not last. Vehicle spoiled again. Now we're in the middle of the bush. If you're traveling, you know, you get to towns, then in Nigeria here, you get to towns and you pass bushes, especially if you're in the north. There's a lot of landmass here in the north, so you pass a lot of just bushes as you're going. Maybe not bushes, farmland, things like that, but you won't really find like a city dwelling in the area. So the thing was that we could manage, but the vehicle had to be going at less than 40 km/h, which is essentially crawling. We did that crawling for like 2 hours till we found a town and repaired our vehicle again. And we're now like, ah, finally, this journey. We now entered Zamfara. You know, it was as if village people were following us. We entered Zamfara. Nothing happened to the bus again. It was now rotary. Rotate stopped our vehicle and our driver refused to stop, which most people do here in Nigeria. But they said that they were going to chase our bus. So they started chasing us. The rotate guy tried to enter the front. He opened the door to enter the front and our driver zoomed up. So he now held on to the door. Yeah, our vehicle now started chasing us. Eventually, after some fast and furious, they caught us and took us to their office. And in the office, they told us to come down from the vehicle that they were not going to leave the driver, that they would find us another vehicle. And so we started the vehicle. We beg. Finally, they let us go. We're now like, who is the Jonah in this bus? We ended up arriving at the Kingari camp around like 1 a.m. in the morning. Thank God, because we're mostly core members, he took us straight to camp. Thank God. We arrived camp, they checked our stuff, checked us into the camp, gave us our bed, showed us our hostel. We now went to the hostel, had our bath, of course, and slept. We went before those things ended, it was like 3 a.m. By 5 a.m., I started hearing people. Soldiers entered our hostel. Get out, get out. It is up, your mama. Where are you living? Is this your father's house? Get out. Hey. Oh my God. Like, I was still so tired from the journey. They matched us, gave us orientation, told us to start registration. We did our registration, we got sorted into our platoons. I'm a doctor, so I had to go to camp cleaning. I was the first to arrive because I arrived a day before camp was supposed to start. So I ended up being camp CMD. That story is for another day. Now, camp was really nice. Did I just say really nice? No, camp was not nice. We know it's about the patrols were always messed up. So we used to have our bats outside around 5 a.m. when it was still dark so that people will not see us. I don't know about the guys, but this was what was happening in the ladies' hostel. Because the bathrooms were Jesus. I don't understand. People who are graduates, there's a toilet too, it's working. There's a bathroom. Let's do that. I made good friends in camp. I did not match you. I went to match one day and my the head of clinic, where because I was camp, said, "Don't be no, that I should go and be minding clinic." So although I snuck out like one or two times to join the matching, but I was really grateful that I did not have to match because, Omo, I served in Kebbi State. Kebbi is the north, and it was when there was sun. Wonder, oh my God! Like when it's afternoon, hey, Chineke, like the sun is really so much. So I was really grateful I did not get to match. In camp, you know, people didn't want to serve in Kebbi. It was so far from everywhere, so people needed to redeploy. So medical redeployment, I got to serve in the panel that was going to interview people for redeployment. Guys, Nigerian students really feel my hand. Like, you know those medical reports that someone will say, I have heart disease, I have asthma, I have this, I have that. You will not even bother going to read up what it is you say you have. Then when you come to the panel, because the panel, there were doctors on the panel, not core doctors only. Like there were doctors that supervise the camp clinic, consultants, that's specialists. So when they are part of the people in the panel. So when you come, I'm like, okay, you give us your medical report. You now look at it. So I think one of the people said they had heart disease. One heart disease, like whether it was angina or something. We now asked him, so how does this? How do you know you have them? They're like, what do you normally feel? What symptoms do you feel? Then I said, he will now feel dizzy. Yeah. Hey, God. The cardinal symptom of angina is chest pain. He never mentioned chest pain. He will have cough to stop. They will admit him and give him this to stop. Like there's Google. Why can't you just check it up on Google? You know? Finally camp ended and we're posted to our PPAs. I got to go to the barrack. When I was in camp, or even out before I came to NYSC, I used to be really afraid of soldiers. Like, although I went to primary school inside a barrack, but somehow I had this fear of soldiers. Our PPA was out in the barrack. But turns out they're actually not that bad, okay? I enjoyed being in the clinic. The soldiers I worked with in the clinic were really, really nice. Now, one of the things that NYSC, one of the things that happened in my NYSC was the language barrier. Like, I didn't, of course, I told you I grew up in Enugu, so I could only speak Igbo and, of course, English. And then, Kevin is a Hausa speaking zone. Hey, God. In fact, the first week that I came, I stopped the bike and I was like, I'm going to so place. But luckily for me, the person could speak English. So the guy said he's speaking Hausa. I told him about Hausa. He said, he now told me in English, you're in Kebbi and you don't know how to speak Hausa. I'm like, yes, I just came 1 week ago. Besides, I know how to speak Igbo. Should I speak Igbo for you? that language barrier thing was really a big deal for me. In fact, when did you see guys this school? There was one day after church, a brother had a birthday, so we're going for his birthday at Plus Center, one of the outing places in Kebbi. And we stopped a bike, say, we're going to Plus Center. The guy said we should enter. We knew he could not understand English, but we said Plus Center, and he said that we should enter. Like, he gestured we should enter. Okay, no, no one amongst us could speak out, so he told him and said, okay, enter. No problem. And so this guy carries the book. We kept on going. Then someone now called, we've gotten there, because we took different people, two people on the bike to get there. We're about six. So me and my sister was on one bike. So our friends were now calling us, you have not arrived since. And we left first. But then I know that turns out the guy did not know where the Plus Center was, and he pretended like he knew. So we just told him, we gave our friend the phone, and he just said, Oga, please bring us back to where you carried us from. And he brought us back to where he carried us from. That's like one of the things that happened because of the language barrier. And it felt so weird to be in a vehicle, you know, people will just be talking. Maybe you're going somewhere and you're in a cab, people will just be talking. You don't understand one thing they are saying. Even though they're not talking to you, but you know that feeling where you don't really understand what anybody's saying. But I think NYC really affected my opinion of the North. But Kebbi people are really nice. Kebbi people don't cheat. At least the ones I met. The first time I came, I entered a bike. The bike man looked at me and told me 100 naira. I didn't know, because transport was really cheap in Kebbi. I felt okay. When I dropped, I felt okay. 100 naira is fair. Now he gave me money. He gave me change. He told me no, that it's not 100 naira, it's 50 naira if I'm going from this place to this place. Like, I didn't even have to ask, and he volunteered the information. I enjoyed serving in Kebbi. I'm given an opportunity to serve again. I think I will go back to Kebbi. Serve. Yes, I didn't like the heat. Jesus. Oh my God. Like, it's in Kebbi that your wall will be hot. The bed will be hot. Jesus. The tiles, you have tiles, and you know normally tiles are cold. The tiles will be hot. The water is hot. Everything is hot. During the around March, April. The heat. That was the only downside for me. The heat is heavy, won't be here. So my general opinion, for me, NYSC was a good experience. I don't think it's a waste of time. A lot of people think it's a waste of time. For someone who grew up in Enugu, did everything in Enugu, was an opportunity to live my life elsewhere, and I really enjoyed it. So yeah, if you have an opportunity to do NYSC somewhere not in your usual comfort zone, just go ahead. It's just 1 year. You get to meet new people, you get to see new food, you get to see new culture, and you generally become a more diverse Nigerian. Which I think that was what the theme was made to be, for people to, Nigeria being so diverse, I mean, for people to see what it is to live with other Nigerians, you know. So tell me in the comment section what your NYC experience was like, you know, things that stood out, events that stood out, whether it's in camp or during the course of the year, friends that you made, where you served. Tell me where you served, okay? I've come to the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching till the end. Remember to subscribe if you've not, and I will see you in the next video. Don't forget to turn on the notification bell so that you would know when I post new videos, okay? Bye.